So we saw Canada's biggest non-bank mortgage lender suffered a crisis of confidence. I guess you and I are having this discussion. I say after alleged broker fraud, but you say it's not just that. There are so many other elements to it. At what point should greater regulation intervention, should we see greater regulatory intervention?
Well, you know, there's the Office of the Superintendent of Financial Institutions, which regulates the banks, and they have several powers that they can kind of employ in these sorts of situations. And industry insiders are saying already at this point, behind the scenes, they're stepping in, sort of taking a look at the books and trying to just sort of mitigate the growing potential of this affecting the greater system. So in some way, they may already be doing some things that we don't quite see. The OSFI is sort of restricted by law for talking about the situation as it's unfolding, but it can at some point potentially take temporary control, or it can broker a sale if there is a willing buyer and they're not seeing the holding company being as cooperative. But mainly, if they see that, you know, let's for say, obviously we're talking about Home Capital, is not looking viable or potentially is not viable sometime soon, they will step in. But that being said, Home Capital has signed from the Healthcare of Ontario Pension Plan a $2 billion emergency sort of backstop. So they're seeing these declines in their deposits that we saw last week. This funding is going to help mitigate the impact of that. It gives them some $3.5 billion in funding, which is quite a bit of a buffer. The other element to that, it's really expensive. So how long this will keep them going, that remains to be seen.
What's next for Home Capital? Like, what are some of the upcoming hurdles that they have?
Well, some of the upcoming events in the immediate term is on May 3rd, they have to report their first quarter earnings. Now, before all of this started coming to a head, before they said that their deposits were falling, and before they said that they needed this credit line, they said that their earnings were quite robust. That it was actually, they pre-released them, and they said that was, it was above what analysts were expecting. But with all of this happening, they've also said that some of these previously announced financial targets that they've said, they may not be able to meet. So, you know, that will give us the first real glimpse. You know, if the company is saying, you know, at the core, our company is sound, this has to do with some issues that happened over 2 years ago. This will give us a real glimpse at the latest financial picture of the company, but also they'll go on an earnings call and they'll have to answer questions from analysts. And no doubt those questions, there are
and
many
journalists?
Yes and no, they don't always take questions. Mm-hmm. Actually, they don't take questions necessarily from journalists on earnings calls. So it'll be the analysts that will be asking the questions, and everybody will be listening to see what they have to say. And no doubt there's many things they'll have to answer to after the week that they had.
Do you think we're seeing a trickle effect into other alternative lenders? Like, what's happening with their stocks? What's happening with their earnings?
Well, for example, today, Equitable Group, another alternative mortgage lender, should have released their earnings on May 11th, but moved to do so today. Why? Because their share price last week was also eroded. They gained a little bit more ground as the week went on, but you know, they said today with their earnings, which actually beat estimates, that they too saw a drawdown in their deposits. Not as much as Home Capital had seen. It was something to like $75 million daily between Wednesday and Friday, and they pegged that as around 2.4% of their deposit base. So not as big an outflow, but still there was an outflow stemming from issues that did not have anything to do with their company. They also signed a $2 billion, they signed a letter of commitment for a $2 billion emergency credit facility, just to make sure their liquidity
is intact. Like a line of credit.
Yeah, just to make sure that if anything else happens, if they see, you know, more declines in their deposits, that they have this as emergency backstop as well.
And their deposits were less than Home Capital, correct? Equitable's
The amount that they saw in
Correct.
Decline, yeah. So, they saw something like $75 million daily from Wednesday to Friday, something around that range. So 2.4% of their deposits. For example, Home Capital last week. I think on Monday, their high interest rate savings deposit balance was at about $1.4 billion. By the end of Friday, they were expecting that to be around $521 million. So it's a much bigger decline.